So we've got this Parkinson's ball base vise this week. Should we get started stripping it down?
First off, let's get the dynamic jaw out. We know what we're doing with that. All the other bits I'm confused with. What comes out first, what undoes. We'll go for this nut underneath, I think. There's actually two nuts under here tightened up against each other to create a lock nut. And this inside one is just finger tight. So obviously that's the key to the ball. Finger tight on the top one, lock up with a spanner on the bottom. Don't lose the washer. Right, who's got the best eyes? Two things wrong with this jaw. One, that screw's broke off in there. Not good. And two, there's a massive chunk missing out of it. Right, let's start off with the broken screw. Now, I find the best thing to do is move up slowly in drill sizes until you're a fraction off the hole size. If you want to check the hole size, use the one on the other end. So take care that you're in the centre, because you don't want to hit the threads. Now, if you look carefully among the swarf when I remove the drill bit, you can see the edge of the screw that was in there. I'm just flicking it back to see if I can catch it with my nail. At this point, quite often the drill bit will flick the remains of that screw out of the thread. I flick this out with a dental pick, clean out the hole, and time to try the screw. Yep, that's good. So I know between the drill and the dental pick, that's all cleaned out. Right, well, that was the easy part, taking out a broken screw, compared to what's coming next. Have a quick think, what would you do? This is what I'm doing, nice and easy. It's only cosmetic. I mean, one, it's not going to get used, it's going to sit on my shelf. But two, that ain't going to take no strain anyway. So I actually let this dry for 24 hours. Because that's what the packet said. And don't forget, we found out in my other video, the fire damaged vise, how good epoxy was on vises. Okay, all primed and undercoated, ready for the top coat. That's disappeared nicely, that edge, hasn't it? Top coat done, in the spray booth. That's about 65 degrees centigrade. 20 minutes of that, hour and a half to cool down. And you can touch it and work with it and reassemble it. Nothing new, they do it when they spray cars. So we'll put this back together here, this is nice and simple. Don't know if this is the original spring, it's very frail and weak looking, very thin for a vise spring. Anyway, pair of pliers, push the washer past the hole, wedge it with your third hand, and put the split pin in. Give it a little tap with the hammer, once you've pushed the spring over at the bottom. Right, entering new ground, how to put it back together. I could watch the video how I took it apart, but it's on this phone that I'm recording this bit with. So I'm pretty sure I took this bit out last, and it came out easy, but it's a bit tight now, but that's the overspray of the paint. So I'm going to give it a little tap. And tighten up its retaining screw. Right, it's much easier to put the oil on while it's apart. You know, I'm being a bit delicate because it only finished drying minutes ago. Right, big nut first, finger tight, little nut. It's got to do up to the big nut. It's preloaded in this socket. Try not to get any oil on the paintwork because this close to being sprayed, it still hasn't cured properly. So, do we remember what it started like? That's right. Okay, so the colour is Balmoral Red. It's a bit deeper than this. This is a bit orangey on camera. Really happy with it now. That's on the shelf. Gonna stay there for life. Okay, honestly, thanks for watching, and I'm gonna say bye for now.